Hey everyone, and welcome back to our channel AI Tech Feed. Today, we are going to deep dive into an AI tool called Emergent, a next-gen AI tool that lets you build apps from the scratch by simply chatting with an AI agent, from prompts to full-stack development. Emergent automates the setup, coding, and even testing. Let's get started.
We are going to walk through how to use the Emergent platform to transform an image into a vector graphic. This technique is incredibly useful for graphic design and web development, especially when you need scalable and editable graphics. Let's dive in and get started. Signing up and getting started with Emergent. First, navigate to the Emergent website. On the homepage, you will see options to sign in or sign up. For a quicker process, let's sign in with Google. Once you've selected your Google account and granted the necessary permissions, you'll be redirected to the main application interface. Exploring the Emergent interface. On the main interface, you will notice a chat input area, which offers you to describe the application you want to create. Before we enter our prompt, take note of the available model options at the top. These include Claude 4.5 Sonnet, Claude 4 Extended, GPT 4.5 Beta. We also have advanced controls where you can select tools such as Custom Memory, Supabase, or Notion Servers, as well as adjust the budget and model settings. For this project, we'll keep the default settings. Defining the application prompt. Now, let's enter our prompt in the chat input box. Instead of creating a generic dashboard, we'll describe a specific application. Let's paste the title and purpose of the app. Image to vector converter web app. The purpose is described as a simple, user-friendly web application that allows users to upload raster images, example PNG or JPEG, and convert them into vector graphics, for example, SVG, using a clean interface and a no-code backend built with Emergent. Configuring requirements with the Emergent agent. With prompt in place, the Emergent agent will ask a few key clarifying questions to confirm our choices for the vector conversion API, conversion settings, user authentication, and key APIs. Once we confirm these details, the agent will begin the process of building the web app. The agent will initialize the cloud environment, then start building both the backend and the frontend. Testing and finalizing the web app. After building the backend and frontend, we receive an update. Excellent, backend is running. Now let me take a screenshot to verify the frontend is working properly. The agent runs a Python script to verify the UI's functionality. After successful verification, the agent tests the conversion functionality using a sample image. The agent reports, "Perfect. The UI is working correctly. Let me test the conversion flow with a real image." The agent performs comprehensive testing, which takes a few moments. Once complete, we get the final message. Thank you for your patience. I've completed the initial implementation and testing of Image to Vector Converter MVP. Previewing the application. The agent presents the live app preview directly in the interface. We can see the title, subheading, and the upload section. The conversion settings allow toggles for color mode, colors, detail level, and smoothness sliders. Below that, we see the vector output section. Let's test the application by clicking the preview button to open the app in a larger window. Testing the conversion process. Now that we are in the preview, we can upload an image. Click the drag and drop area, select a file, and upload an image. For example, a red animated car. The image uploads successfully and appears on the left side of the screen. Adjust the conversion settings to get the best results. tweaking the sliders for colors, detail level, and smoothness. For this example, we'll set the detail level to 6. Click the Convert to Vector button. A loading animation appears, followed by the Conversion Complete message. The newly converted vector graphic is displayed in the Vector Output panel. We can now click Download as SVG and the file is successfully downloaded. Final testing and deployment. To confirm, let's open the downloaded SVG in the browser. The crisp, scalable vector graphic of the red car is there, proving the conversion works flawlessly. Back in the Emergent chat interface, we have a few options. Save to GitHub, Preview, Fork, Ultra for more powerful processing, and Share that generates a public shareable link. We'll click the Share option, copy the public link, and open it in a new tab. The live app loads instantly, confirming that the image-to-vector converter is fully functional and ready for deployment. Conclusion. This demonstrates the full power of Emergent, taking a detailed natural language prompt and tuning it into a production-ready web application. Thank you for joining this tutorial. Subscribe AI Tech Feed for more such awesome videos.